Hello dear friends, welcome to the channel BSc Classes Studies. Today we are going to discuss about the next chapter after the completion of Lichen's syllabus. We are moving towards, as it is given in your university syllabus, about the bryophyte studies. So bryophytes are very interesting group of plants in which they are considered as ancestors of modern plants, the modern plants which are flowering plants. These bryophytes are considered as the ancestor of these plants. So these bryophytes are very interesting creature because they are considered as a plant, but they do not show any peculiar characteristic like modern plants because they do not show true root, true leaves and true stem like features. So I welcome you once again. We are going to discuss in detail about all these points. Myself, Professor Khodde Rishikesh, working as assistant professor in Department of Botany at S.M. Joshi College, Hadapsar, Pune, which is belonging to the parent institute Raya Shikshan Samstha Sathara. My college is affiliated to the Savitribai Phule Pune University. So without wasting too much time, let's get started of today's lecture, that is bryophyte studies. Okay, here behind on the screen, I have shown you one beautiful photograph of bryophyte. The bryophytic plants are very small in size. They are often considered as microscopic. We require a magnifying lens or macro type of lens of camera to observe these types of plants. So these bryophytes are named as a bryophyte on the basis of name bryon. The bryon means it is Latin name considered as a moss type of plants. These bryophytes are very interestingly present on the evolutionary tree. On the screen I have shown you the chart of plant kingdom, which is divided into certain groups. These bryophytes are the between thallophytes and pteridophytes. Thallophytes means those have a thallophytic type of body, but bryophytes are showing somewhat advanced type of body. But the pteridophytes, these are very advanced type of plants because they contain true vascular system which is absent in bryophytic plants. So these bryophytic plants are considered as intermediate to the thallophyte and pteridophyte, and these bryophytes are lacking the vascular tissues. These bryophytes are lacking vascular tissue is the reason why they occur near to the water areas. They require water for their reproduction purpose. Please note down this point, because bryophytes are the plants who require water for their reproduction. They are gametophytic plant bodies. Gametophytic plant body means they directly releases the gametes outside the body, which gametes get united and result into the formation of sporophyte. So these gametophytic bryophytes, which are lacking vascular tissues, the picture behind me showing the bryophytic plant where you will not find any leaf-like structure or any root-like structure, but the analogous part, which are functioning like a leaf and functioning like a root, are present in these bryophytes. The example is Merkantia, which is I am giving here. So these bryophytes we are going to study in distinct point, such as the location where they are occur, the style of the growth of the bryophyte, the vegetative part description and reproductive part description, the life cycle description and other features of these bryophytes. Okay, we are talking about here the general characters of bryophytes as shown in the picture. These bryophytes occurrence point of view occur near to the water area compulsory, because already we have said that they are lacking vascular tissues. Vascular tissues means the tissue which are present in the plant which conduct the water with minerals. So after lacking the vascular tissues, it is compulsory to stay near to the plant. That's why these bryophytes are considered as plant amphibians or amphibians of plants. What is amphibian? The picture is showing some amphibian animals. These amphibian animals capable of living inside the water and outside of water on the basis of their respiratory system. Also they require water for reproduction in case of animals, but in case of plants, these bryophytes require water for reproduction. This is the concept behind this, to call them as amphibians of plants. The point which we are talking here is respect to the habitat of bryophyte. The location of occurrence is near to the water and requirement of water for the reproduction. The next point is habit of bryophytes. Habit means the morphological point of view of the bryophytic plant body. Morphology means the external appearance study of the bryophyte. So the morphological features are very crucial. Here in the image you can see that the bryophyte contain smaller root like portion, smaller leaf like portion. The leaves like portions are often dorsiventrally flattened, and root like portion are very minute, which are involved in absorption of water and giving support to the plant. But they do not contain true root and true leaves like structure, which is very important thing you should remember in your mind. So these bryophytes, if you are talking, contain three major classes. They are divided in three different groups, and each group showing the highlighted features of the bryophytes. So here I am classifying the bryophytes into three groups, namely the liverwort, hornwort and mussel. So these three groups of bryophyte showing somewhat differences and somewhat similarities between them. So here we are interesting to see what are the differences and what are the similarities in these three different bryophytes. Okay, we will discuss them in the area where it is needed. Here I am highlighting the point of vegetative reproduction in bryophytes. What is reproduction? First of all, you should know the reproduction meaning the continuation of species. Every species on this planet has perspective to continue its generation after generation. So for this, many different species have occupied the different strategies. For human being, we have sexual reproduction. But plants are very smart. They have vegetative, asexual and sexual are different types of reproduction methodologies in plant. I have highlighted the vegetative reproduction point. Vegetative reproduction means the part of the plant is directly involved in the reason of creation of new generation. What does it mean? The photograph showing the bryophytic plant body, the division of the parts of this bryophytic plant body will result into formation of new organisms of bryophytes. So it is very interesting why a bryophyte would show this type of division of their own parts, because in stress condition where very scarcity of water, during that period this bryophyte generally shows this type of reproduction, that is vegetative type of reproduction. The breakdown of their own thallus is known as fragmentation method of vegetative reproduction. Whereas the another type of reproduction which is I have highlighted is sexual type of reproduction. So what is sexual type of reproduction? Sexual reproduction is considered as which involves the gamete formation method. So gametes are of two types, male gamete and female gamete. The reproduction of bryophytic sexual reproduction is oogamous type. Oogamous means the name oogamous, capital O, small O, gamous. So this type, this name is very descriptive. Male gamete is smaller in size and female gamete is larger in size. If the difference is in gamete size, then it is this type of reproduction is known as oogamous type of reproduction. Then the question is, from where male gamete comes and from where female gamete comes. So for this, in sexual reproduction, we will have to go in detail for the structure of male gamete, structure of male reproductive organ, from where male gametes are generated, and structure of female reproductive organ where the female gametes are generated. But please remember that the male gamete size is always smaller as compared to the female gamete, and male gametes are motile. They have flagella for movement. They move from one location to the other location as shown in the picture, and the female gamete is stationary, which reside on the one location. Male gamete go in the search of female gamete and find it and result into the formation of zygote, which result into the formation of embryo and sporophyte respectively. So here we are discussing about the structure of male reproductive organ and female reproductive organ. Later we will go in detail about these structures in case of study of life cycle of bryophytes. Here just we are looking at the general scenario of male and female reproductive organ. In the picture you can see that male reproductive organ and female reproductive organ are different in their looks. So the sexual reproduction is dependent upon the reproductive organ, and the reproductive organ are male reproductive organ and female reproductive organ. The male reproductive organs produces male gametes and female reproductive organ produces female gametes. Male gametes are smaller, female gametes are larger. So the differences in gamete size is known as oogamous type of reproduction. Male gamete produced by the male reproductive organ. The male reproductive organ is known as antheridium, and female reproductive organ is known as archegonium. Please note down these points in your notebooks. So antheridium and archegonium are present on the same thallus. You should point out these points. Archegonium produces female gametes, antheridium produces male gametes, which are present on the same thallus. Antheridium releases the male gametes, which are motile, and archegonium contains female gamete, which is stationary. A union of these gametes results into the formation of zygote. Zygote is unicellular. Gametes are also unicellular. Two unicellular gametes comes together to form unicellular zygote. But the differences in their ploidy status. Ploidy status means gametes are haploid and zygote is diploid. So the zygote undergoes the division and redivision. Zygote is unicellular, but it undergoes continuous division and result into the formation of embryo. This embryo are multicellular, but you should remember that the zygote first division is horizontal. So in the diagram which is given on the screen, the horizontal division result into the formation of two cells into the zygote. The upper cell will result into the formation of complete thallus, and the lower cell result into the formation of different purpose. But the thallus formation is dependent upon the upper cell. So the embryo is multicellular, it is clear. That's why bryophytes are also known as embryophytes. The terminology is given by the scientist, embryophyte, to the bryophyte, because they contain multicellular embryo. The zygote first divide into two cells by horizontal method. Due to that, upper cell will produce the thallus, not directly thallus, but it again undergo the division and redivision and produces embryo. The embryo, which is the product of division in zygote, this embryo will form the structure which is a diploid in status. Please remember, the thallus is haploid, which produces gametes, which are haploid. These gametes unites to form zygote. This zygote is diploid, and this zygote result into the formation of embryo, which is also diploid. This embryo will result into the formation of sporophyte. These sporophyte are dependent upon the gametophyte. So in bryophyte, you will find two types of generations. One is gametophytic generation and another is sporophytic generation. The sporophytic generation is dependent upon the gametophytic generation. From where sporophytic generation came? From the embryo. From where embryo came? From zygote. From where zygote came? By the union of gametes. And from where the gamete came? From the male reproductive organ, antheridium, and female reproductive organ, archegonium. So it is clear up to you now. In bryophyte, gametophyte and sporophyte are two alternative generations you can observe. The sporophytes in bryophyte case dependent upon the gametophyte. These sporophytes rupture and releases the spores. These spores are haploid. So you must be confused now. If sporophytes are diploid, how the spores are haploid? The spores are produced by the division type, which is known as meiosis, which is you know very well. Meiosis result into formation of haploid cells. So these sporophytes releases the spores in air, which land somewhere and result into formation of new thallus. So it is very interesting that gametophytic thallus produces sporophyte. This sporophyte releases spores, which land somewhere and gives new generation or new thallus, which will be the gametophytic. So this is the sort of reproduction in bryophyte which we will discuss in our upcoming lecture. Here it is just introductory to you about general characters of bryophytes, introduction to the bryophytes, and I am sure it must be clear up to you what is the actual meaning of bryophyte, why they call as a bryophyte, why they call as a embryophyte, why they occur near to the water. So these are the very minute points which are very essential with respect to the competitive exams as well as to pass out your FYBSC. So let's stay tuned. We will meet in next lecture with the more detailed information with respect to the bryophytes, about the division in their classes, description of each and every classes which we have highlighted in this lecture. Thank you very much for your time. Please don't forget to subscribe this lecture. We will meet in our next lecture. Thank you.